Good morning, children. So here we are starting with the part 7 of the chapter Admission of a Partner. In the previous part, we discussed about the rules, format, and journal entries of revaluation account. And in this part, we are going to proceed with a practical question on revaluation account. As you can see, the question says, A and B were in partnership sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:1. On 1st April 2018, they admit C as a partner on the following terms. So there are two partners, A and B. The old PSR is 3:1 and they are admitting a new partner C on the following terms and conditions. The first term is that C brings rupees 1 lakh as his capital and rupees 50,000 for goodwill, half of which is to be withdrawn by A and B. So that means C is bringing 1,50,000 in cash total, out of which 1 lakh he is bringing for capital and 50,000 he is bringing for goodwill, half of which is to be withdrawn by A and B. So the goodwill which he is bringing has to be distributed among the sacrificing partners in the sacrificing ratio. And since no hint about the new ratio is given or any sacrifice is given, so we will assume the old ratio to be the sacrificing ratio. So the journal entry, if we have to pass for the capital and goodwill brought in by C, the entry would be bank account debited or cash account debited. Now, till now we were using bank, but where you have the balance sheet or the previous information or in the question, in that case you have to see whether the firm is having cash in hand or bank. If it is having cash, then in your entries you will be writing cash account instead of bank. If it is having bank, then you will be writing bank. And if no such information is given, then you can very comfortably write bank. In this question, we can see clearly that in the balance sheet, cash in hand is given. So therefore, in case of bank, we will be writing cash account. So the entry, if we have to pass, because I have not read the question till now, so just explaining you point by points so that it becomes easier for you. And then at the end, we will see the full-fledged solution. So if we have to pass the entry for the capital and goodwill brought in by C, the entry would be bank account debited 1,50,000 because 1 lakh he is bringing for capital and 50,000 he is bringing for goodwill. To C's capital account 1 lakh because he is bringing 1 lakh for capital. And to premium for goodwill account 50,000 because he is bringing 50,000 as goodwill. Now this 50,000 of goodwill has to be distributed among the sacrificing partners in the sacrificing ratio. And since in this question no further information is given regarding the sacrificing ratio or the new ratio so that we can apply the formula and calculate, we will assume that A and B are sacrificing in the old ratio itself. So what we will do, we will divide the 50,000 premium for goodwill among A and B in the ratio of 3:1. So the entry for distributing this premium would be premium for goodwill account debited 50,000 to A's capital account and to B's capital account. We will divide 50,000 in the ratio of 3:1. Half of which is to be withdrawn by A and B, and we have learned that either the goodwill can be retained in the business or it may be withdrawn. So they are withdrawing, the old partners are withdrawing half of the goodwill they have got. So in that case, what we will do, we will pass an additional entry for goodwill withdrawn. The entry will be A's capital account debited, B's capital account debited to goodwill. No, instead of goodwill, what do we credit? We credit cash or bank. So in this case, cash is given in the balance sheet, so we will credit to cash account. And whatever amount of goodwill they are getting, half of it will be withdrawn. The term B, the second condition. that the value of land and building to be appreciated by 15%. Appreciated means the value of land and building is increasing or increased by 15%. So land and building is an asset. An increase in asset by 15%. So any increase in asset is shown on the credit side of revaluation account. So if you see the value of land and building is 3,30,000. So we'll have to take out the 15% of 3,30,000. Whatever will be the increase will be shown on the credit side of revaluation account by land and building, and in the amount column we will write the increased value. The journal entry for this will be, because it is an increase in asset, so land and building account will be debited. What is to be credited? Revaluation account. So entry will be land and building account debited with the increased value to revaluation account. And that of stock and machinery and fixtures to be reduced by 7 and 5% respectively. That means the value of stock decreases or reduces by 7% and machinery and fixtures decreases by 5%. So these are the decrease in the value of asset, because stock and machinery and fixtures are assets. So any decrease in the value of assets will be shown on the debit side of revaluation account. We will write two stock on the debit side of revaluation account with the decreased value, and two machinery and fixtures on the debit side of revaluation account again with the decreased value. The entry for decrease in assets will be revaluation account debited to stock account to machinery and fixtures account. Why? Because these are assets, and decrease in assets, if there is a decrease in assets, the asset account is credited in case of journal entry. So as you can see, the value of stock in the balance sheet shown is 1,80,000, and its value is decreasing by 7%. So we have to calculate 7% of 1,80,000. It will show the decrease. And machinery and fixtures, the value is 2,00,000, which is reducing by 5%. So we will calculate 5% of 2,00,000. That will be the decreased value, which will be shown in the revaluation account and the journal entry. Point C, that provision for doubtful debts to be made at 5%. And in class 11th, you have studied that whatever provision for doubtful debts is to be maintained, that is maintained on debtors. So this 5% of provision will be calculated on debtors, which is also known as book debts, as given on the asset side. The book debts are rupees 2,00,000, and we will calculate the provision of 5% on 2,00,000. So by calculating the provision, basically provision is a kind of a liability. And if you see that it also reduces the asset. So provision is basically a kind of a liability. And if we are creating the provision, that means our liability is increasing. So it will be shown on the debit side of revaluation account with the amount will be 5% of 2,00,000. And the journal entry for this will be revaluation account debited to provision for doubtful debts account. Why provision is credited? Because it is a liability. So in case of journal entry, liability carries a credit balance. Therefore, we have credited provision account. And what else is to be debited? Revaluation account. Point D, that 15,000 to be provided for an unforeseen liability, means for a liability which is not seen, which is expected, unforeseen, mean it might happen, it might occur, and it was not recorded beforehand. Now you are recording it. That means it is an unrecorded liability, and if you are recording it right now, it will increase the liability. This 15,000 will be shown on the debit side of revaluation account because it is increasing the liability. So on the debit side of revaluation account, we will write to unforeseen liability rupees 15,000. And the entry for this will be revaluation account debited to unforeseen liability account 15,000. Why we are crediting it? Because it is an increase in liability. Then the E point. C to be given 1/5 share and the profit sharing ratio between A and B to remain the same. So C is coming for 1/5 share and the PSR between A and B will be the same, means it will be 3:1. The balance sheet of the old partnership as at 31st March 2018 stood as asset side cash in hand 40,000, book debts or debtors 2 lakh, stock 1,80,000, machinery and fixtures 2 lakh, land and building 3,30,000, and on the debits liabilities side sundry creditors 3,50,000, capital accounts of A 4 lakh and B 2 lakh, that means 6 lakh. So the total of balance sheet on the liabilities and asset side is 9,50,000 each. And there is one more condition, if you see point number F, that 11,000 is to be received as commission, hence to be accounted for. 11,000 is to be received for commission. That means it has not been received till now. That means it is an outstanding commission to be received. It is an outstanding income. It is now to be accounted for. That means it is now to be recorded. So outstanding income or outstanding commission to be received is an asset which was not recorded before. Now we are recording. That means it is an increase in asset and it will be shown on the credit side of revaluation account by outstanding commission 11,000. And the journal entry for this will be outstanding commission account debited to revaluation account. Since it is an asset, therefore we have debited it. And what is to be credited so as to make it balanced? It will be revaluation account. And be very, very, very careful with the date. The balance sheet of A and B which is given to you is on 31st March 2018. But the new partner C is admitting on 1st April 2018. So if the question asks, because till now we have not read what the question is asking you, but if the question asks to make a new balance sheet of the new firm as well, then the date of that new balance sheet will be 1st April 2018. That means the date of admission and not 31st March. So if you write 31st March 2018, whereas the partner is admitting on 1st April, you will lose your marks which is allotted on the date. Now the question, give necessary journal entries, ledger accounts and the balance sheet of the newly constituted firm. So what you have to do in this question, you have to pass the journal entries, you have to prepare the ledger accounts. Which ledger account, it is not mentioned, so whatever, how many ledger accounts are required, you will prepare that. So we will be preparing the capital accounts of the partners and the revaluation account. And also you have to prepare the balance sheet of the newly constituted firm. That means the new firm which is there, in which C is also a partner. And as we were discussing right now, that the date of this new balance sheet at the time of admission, incorporating C's adjustments as well, will be 1st April 2018. That is the date of admission and not 31st March 2018. So let us start with the solution. I have already briefed you the question. Revaluation account, left hand side we have shown the debit side and right hand side we have shown the credit side. Debit side we will record the value or the increase in the value of liabilities and decrease in the value of assets. So if you remember, the value of stock was reducing by 7%. So the 7% reduced of the stock value which is given in the question. As you can see, the value of stock is 1,80,000. तो 7% ऑफ 1,80,000 विल बी 12,600 विच विल बी शोन ऑन द डेबिट साइड. देन मशीनरी एंड फिक्स्चर्स इज ऑल्सो रिड्यूसिंग बाई 5%. एंड इन द बैलेंस शीट द वैल्यू ऑफ मशीनरी एंड फिक्स्चर्स वर 2 लाख, सो 5% ऑफ 2 लाख विल बी 10,000. देन there was a provision to be created at the rate 5% on book debts or the debtors. So the value of book debts or the debtors given in the balance sheet was 2 lakh, and 5% of 2 lakh is rupees 10,000. Then there was an unforeseen liability 15,000. Unforeseen, which was not recorded beforehand. If you are recording it right now, that means it will increase the liability. So on the debit side of revaluation account, we will show 2 unforeseen liability 15,000. On the credit side, if you read the terms and conditions once again, which were given before, that the value of land and building is to be appreciated by 15%. Appreciated means increased by 15%, and depreciated means decreased. So in this question, you have to appreciate it. So the value of land and building given in the balance sheet was 3,30,000. And if it is increasing by 15%, so 15% of 3,30,000 will be 49,500. It is an increase in asset, therefore we are showing it on the credit side. Then there was an outstanding commission to be received worth rupees 11,000, which was to be accounted for. So it was not recorded before, it is an outstanding income. Now it will be recorded, it is an increase in asset, and therefore it will be shown on the credit side of revaluation account by outstanding commission 11,000. So after posting all the increases and decreases in the assets and liabilities, we will compare the credit side with the debit side. If the credit side is more than the debit side, it will be a profit. So in our case also, the credit side is more than the debit side, therefore there is a profit of rupees 12,900. So this 12,900 of revaluation profit will be transferred to A's capital account and B's capital account in their old ratio, as a result of which A will be getting 9,675 and B will be getting 3,225. So ultimately the total of revaluation account on the debit and credit side will come to 60,500 each. Let us have a look at the journal entry. Now do remember children, irrespective whether the information of new partner is given before or the old firm is given before, irrespective, you have to settle all the accounts of the old partners before incorporating the entries for the new partner. That means before recording the capital or goodwill brought in by the new partner and the further entries for distribution of goodwill among the sacrificing partners, or the entry for withdrawal of goodwill by the sacrificing partners. Before passing these entries, you have to pass the entries for revaluation account. Or if there is any old goodwill given in the balance sheet which you need to write off, all this has to be done before recording the entries of the new partner. So here we will record the entry of revaluation first. As you can see, the date, because revaluation is prepared on the date of reconstitution, whenever a partner is admitted or retired or death. So in this case, the partner is coming on 1st April. So the revaluation entries will also be passed on 1st April 2018. So the first entry is for the debit side. That means decrease in assets and increase in liability. It is a combined entry. So revaluation account debited to stock account, because stock is decreasing, therefore it is credited because it is an asset, and if it decreases, it carries a credit balance. So to stock account, how much the stock is decreasing? 12,600. To machinery and fixtures account, how much machinery and fixtures are decreasing? 10,000. Then to provision for doubtful debts, how much the provision is or liability is increasing? 10,000. Then two unforeseen liability 15,000. How much the unforeseen liability is increasing? Because it was not recorded before, 15,000. So ultimately 47,600 will be debited to revaluation account. It comprises both the increase in liabilities and decrease in assets. Basically the accounting for debit side of revaluation account. And as you can see the narration, for decrease in assets and increase in liabilities. Then the second entry, again on the same date, April 1st. This is the entry for credit side of revaluation account. That means increase in assets. The entry is land and building account debited 49,500, because this is the value of asset or land and building increased. It is a asset. It is an asset, and if the value of asset increases, it is debited. Similarly, outstanding commission account debited 11,000, because before hands it was not recorded. Now we are recording it. That means it will increase the asset. Two, revaluation account. That means the total of 60,500 will be credited to revaluation account, which comprises of increase in different assets. So as you can see the narration, for increase in assets. Then there was a profit of 12,900 in revaluation account, which is to be distributed among the old partners in the old ratio. So we are, if we are giving the profit to the partners in their capital or current account, it will increase their capital balance, the liability. That means it will be credited. And what is to be debited? Revaluation account. So the entry for transfer of profit will be revaluation account debited, that is with the profit amount 12,900, to A's capital account 9,675, to B's capital account 3,225 for revaluation profit distributed in the old ratio. That means we have distributed the profit of 12,900 in the old ratio. Now, since we have passed all the entries related to the old firm, now we will start with the entries of the new partner. So the first entry, again the same date of admission, the entry will be cash account debited. Why we are writing cash and not bank? Because in this case, in the balance sheet, cash is given. So we will write the entry cash account debited 1,50,000, because in totality, C is bringing 1,50,000, out of which 1 lakh he is bringing for capital. So to C's capital account 1 lakh, and 50,000 he is bringing for goodwill. Therefore to premium for goodwill account 50,000. The narration will be for amount of capital and goodwill premium brought in cash. Now this goodwill premium of 50,000 is to be distributed among the sacrificing partners in the sacrificing ratio. And in this question, no as such hint or information is given about the sacrificing ratio or new ratio. Therefore, we will assume the old ratio 3:2 to be the sacrificing ratio. So the next entry, again on the same date of admission, will be premium for goodwill account debited 50,000. When we had received the premium, it was credited. Now when we are distributing it, it will be debited to A's capital account 37,500 and to B's capital account 12,500. That is, we have divided the premium of 50,000 in the sacrificing ratio. The narration can be for goodwill premium transferred to old partner's capital in sacrificing ratio. And if you remember, then while admitting C, there was one condition that the partners will withdraw half of their goodwill. So the third entry related to new partner is the entry for withdrawal of goodwill by the sacrificing partners. When the partners are withdrawing goodwill, their capital balance will decrease and therefore it will be debited. So A's capital account debited 18,750. This is 50% or half of the goodwill which he got, that is 37,500. So out of 37,500, he is withdrawing half, that means 18,750. Then B's capital account debited against 6,250. It is half of what B has got, that is 12,500. So half of 12,500 will be 6,250. That means A is withdrawing 18,750 and B is withdrawing 6,250. So ultimately the cash account will be credited with 25,000. That means in totality, how much cash is going out of the firm? 25,000. The narration will be for goodwill premium withdrawn by the partners. So these were the journal entries and revaluation account related to this question. Now the partners capital account, because the question had asked you to prepare the ledger accounts. So we have prepared revaluation account. Now we are preparing partners capital account. Again, debit side and credit side. There are three partners, A, B and C. So we have shown the three amount column of each three partners, both on the debit and the credit side. So since the capital account balance is given in the old balance sheet, and that is a credit balance, so opening balance will be shown on the credit side if it is credit. So we will write by balance brought down. It is 4 lakh as given in the balance sheet, and in case of B it is 2 lakh. C, the opening balance is not given because C is the new incoming partner. Then now what we have to do is, because of the transaction or due to any transaction, if the capital balance increases, it will be shown on the credit side, and if it decreases, will be shown on the debit side. So on the credit side, we will write the reasons due to which the capital balance has increased. So it has increased due to revaluation profit. So on the credit side, we will write by revaluation, A has got profit of 9,675, B has got profit of 3,225, and C has not got any revaluation profit because C is the new partner. Then when C is bringing the capital, with that amount of capital of 1 lakh, also the capital of C would increase. Therefore, on the credit side, we have to write by bank account, or here you will be writing by cash account because it is given in the balance sheet. So by cash or bank account, both are basically acceptable. You will write 1 lakh in the amount column, and then the premium for goodwill which he is bringing will be distributed among the old partners, among the sacrificing partners in the sacrificing ratio, as a result of which the capital account of sacrificing partners will also increase. So on the credit side, we will show by premium for goodwill of the sacrificing partners. So in the column for A, it will be 37,500, and in the column of B, it will be 12,500. C is not getting because he is the person who is bringing it. So these are the items because of which the capital balances of partners has increased. On the debit side, we will show the items because of which the capital balance has decreased. So the first is two bank account or two cash account as per this question. This is the amount of goodwill withdrawn by the sacrificing partners, as a result of which their capital is decreasing. So A is withdrawing 18,750 and B is withdrawing 6,250. C is not withdrawing anything because he is not getting the goodwill, rather he is bringing the goodwill. So these were the items related to this question which were shown on the credit and debit side of partners capital account. After writing all this, you will compare the debit and the credit side, and you will calculate the balancing figure. You will total the credit side minus the total of debit side, whatever will be the balancing figure, that will be shown on the respective side. So in this case, in this question, the credit side for all the partners is more and the debit side for all the partners is less. That means the closing balance will be shown on the debit side so as to make both the sides equal. And the closing balance will be written as to balance carried down. So in case of A, the closing balance to balance carried down is 4,28,425. In case of B, it is 2,09,475, and in case of C, it is 1,00,000. So ultimately, the total of the three partners will be 4,47,175 for A, 2,15,225 for B, and 1,00,000 for C. So whatever closing balances we have calculated for A, B, and C, that will be shown in the balance sheet. So we have prepared the ledger accounts, that is the revaluation account and partner's capital account, and we have also passed the journal entries. Now is the time for balance sheet of the newly constituted firm. So as you can see, balance sheet as at 1st April 2018. In the common and comparative size balance sheet, which we have discussed in the month of April and May, I already explained to you that you need to write as at the date of balance sheet. The same applies in case of partnership chapter also. Whenever you are preparing the balance sheet, you have to write below balance sheet, you have to write the date. And in case of partnership and company, you will be writing as at. Now the rule of as on has been removed. As at has been made compulsory for company accounts, and the same is followed for partnership. No doubt it is not compulsory, but the council requires you to write as at in case of partnership also. So to be on the safer side, make it a habit. So you will write balance sheet as at, and since you have to make the balance sheet of the reconstituted firm, of the new firm, that means at the time of admission of C, and C is admitting on 1st April. Remember children, if you write 31st March 2018, it will be wrong. You will lose your marks allotted on the date. So you have to be very careful about it. The date will be as at 1st April 2018. It is a balance sheet. Left hand side is the liabilities column, right hand side is the assets column. And while preparing the new balance sheet, you will incorporate all the changes which were there in the asset and liability. If there was any asset or liability in which there was no change, it will be copied as it is. And if there is an asset the value of which has increased, then you will write the value after such increase. If there was any decrease, then you will write the value after such decrease. So the first and the foremost asset in the previous year balance sheet or in the previous balance sheet was cash in hand, which was given as 40,000 in the previous balance sheet. Now in the new balance sheet, as you can see, I have written cash in hand 1,65,000. So how we have arrived at that, you can see the working of cash in hand at the end. That is, 40,000 was given in the balance sheet of A and B, plus it has increased because new partner C has brought 1,50,000 for capital and goodwill, and minus 25,000 because the old partners, the sacrificing partners, have withdrawn goodwill in cash. So 40,000 was the previous balance sheet balance, plus 1,50,000 C has brought, minus 25,000 the sacrificing partners have withdrawn as goodwill. So ultimately the actual balance of cash is 1,65,000. Then book debts, in the previous balance sheet the value was 2,00,000, but we have created a provision and provision is to be deducted. So 5% provision is created, that is 10,000. So ultimately the actual value of book debts now is 1,90,000. Then stock, there was a decrease in the value of stock by 7%. So after deducting the decrease balance here, after deducting the 7% amount, the ultimately actual balance, the revalued balance of stock now is 1,67,400. Machinery and fixtures, the previous value was 2,00,000, but it has reduced by 5%. That means 10,000 has been deducted. So the actual value is 1,90,000 now. Land and building, the previous balance was 3,30,000, which has now been appreciated or increased by 15%. So after adding 15% of 3,30,000 to it, the actual value now, the revaluation, is 3,79,500. Then there was an outstanding commission which was not recorded in the previous balance sheet. Now we will record because it is an asset. So it will be 11,000 on the asset side. As you see, we have not shown the bifurcation of increase and decrease in the balance sheet. That you have to add it or reduce it, and without showing the bifurcation, you have to write it here. Only the provision we have shown because it is the part of the format. Then on the liabilities side, there was no change in the creditors. So we have copied the creditors as it is, 3,50,000. Then there was unforeseen liability of 15,000, which was not recorded before, but now it is recorded. So we have shown it on the liabilities side. And then the closing balance of capital account, the new closing balance after admitting C and incorporating all the terms and conditions. The closing balance of A is 4,28,425. That of B is 2,09,475. And C is 1 lakh. That means the total capital of all the three partners is 7,37,900. So ultimately the balance sheet will automatically, without any balancing figure, it will get tallied with the amount, as you can see on that asset and the liability side, 1,102,900. This is the value. The balance sheet will be tallied by 11,02,900 on the asset and the liabilities side. So this is a very good full-fledged question where you have to make the revaluation account, the partner's capital account, you have to pass the journal entries, and also you have to prepare the balance sheet of the newly constituted firm. This is the assignment based on the question discussed in this video. You have to answer the following questions in your register. You have to redo the question taught in this video. The question which we have discussed here in this part, you have to do it again on your own in your register. And question number 2, you have to solve practical question number 37 from the chapter Admission of a Partner of Your Accounts book by D.K. Goyal, volume 1. So these two questions you have to answer in your registers. Go through the video once again, children, revise the question and complete your written work. Thank you.